Hello everyone, welcome to a new legacy video. Finally we get some brand 6 to sling in those legacy leagues, in those legacy videos. So yeah, I guess I forgot to say welcome everyone to a new legacy video. Today we're playing brand 6, my friend. And what's the shell though? This Tower of Secrets, this deck is weird. This deck that won the legacy challenge last weekend. Spent 20 lands with 4 wasteland, definitely a lot for those Delver decks. But that's because we are not a normal like Delver Dates deck like you used to see. We play 3 Vernon 6, 3 Abrupt Decay, 4 Tarmogoyf, 2 Dreadlord Arcanist, and 2 True Nemesis. So definitely a lot of expensive cards. So we need land drops. And this is gone. Cantrips, a couple of thoughts is as well, because you are our 4 color here. We're splashing black in the mix. Not sure if you should put. Guess that's the thing, maybe, you know, less wasteland around, you can play some, let's see, what is it, Underground Sea Ren 6, or some Volcanic Island Abrupt Decay. Those are definitely the numbers of these kinds of decks, but this is things that are happening with Deathrite Shaman around, maybe now we're seeing 4 color again, Control, as well as 4 color again, Delver, and those are 2 decks that I'm gonna record with, and yep, here we are. In the cyber we have a Force of Negation, good against Chalice and combo decks, Beb, as well as 3 Pyroblast, a couple of Winter Orb, which is very, very good against Miracles. Surgical Plug Engineer is now the cool toy, you can board it in very many matchups. A couple of Diabolic Edicts and a Sylvan Library, again for Miracles matchup. So yep, let's see if this Vran 6 can show some strength in Legacy. And don't forget that this is ChannelFireball.com and this is Andrea Mengucci, which you can support via ChannelFireball.com by purchasing from the website using the link in the description of the video in order to support me and also ChannelFireball, of course. All right, let's start this on the play. Let's see if we got a great hand. The first 3 cards are exactly what you want to see. Land the Delver Days. And we also got a Vran 6, so yeah, things are looking good indeed. I don't know if I want to Daze immediately, maybe we just wanna, yeah, Cloud Post, okay. Yep, let's go with Delver. Vran 6 unfortunately does not flip Delver, but what it does is, alright, so I don't have a Bayou in this deck, so I can't get access to black. So you need to get Tropical Island, the only land that produces green, in fact. So let's immediately return target land and attack for 1. Maybe in upkeep now we want to brainstorm since we don't have much to do with our lands and yep. So I want to tap the Volcanic so I can draw Tarmogoyf and still be able to play it. Our Social Spyglass now can stop my brand. But Vran is definitely not. I mean, this matchup is fine because you can get Wasteland, but yeah. But they're gonna probably just name it. Oh, maybe they just name Wasteland. Yeah, they name Wasteland. It actually makes sense. So I'm gonna tap Bulk, so if I draw a Tarmogoyf, I can still play it. Okay, so I'm definitely gonna get rid of this, and maybe just a Volcanic Island. Oh, I'm so stupid. For some reasons, my apologies, my friends. For some reason, I thought we were in a main phase. Yeah, that was definitely awful. All right, let's get this Underground Sea. Let's get the land back. And let's attack and pass the turn. Missing big damage here, and that's how you beat that deck, by just clocking them. I don't know, this is not a good start of this video, but it's okay. It is very much normal to make those kind of mistakes. Alright, I mean, of course, what I should have done was just to put a Ponder of Days on top of the deck and then reveal it to Delver. Alright, so they have access to 4 mana, but luckily they don't do anything with it. So I'm gonna go this and then just start looking for a Wasteland to kill our opponent. Yeah, see if this Delver flips. Nope, yeah, obviously. We are gonna rightfully be punished by our sloppiness. Yeah, it's definitely not the cards they want to see. Can I just play a Trunem Nemesis here? Maybe my opponent, and then I'll, yeah, I guess I should have just fetched to just gain the value. I wanted to ping my opponent, but then I thought that maybe the emblem is actually a thing here. Our opponent knows about their days, so they will not play around it. They will not play around it. Still on 23 life, yeah, again. Alright, that's an easy concession. Did not draw that wasteland, and I got defeated. Alright, Winter Orb is definitely good in the matchup as well as Ancient Grudge. Force of Negation is very good against any deck with Chalice of the Void. And I'm not sure about these Diabolic Edicts, we'll see. So Renin 6, I don't think it's that good in this matchup. You can shave. Lightning Bolt, you can shave. And what's the last card that I want to cut? Maybe a land? This deck at the end of the day is very land heavy. Let's just cut a Volcanic Island. Now let's go with this. Alright, vamos. Yep, this is not amazing, but we do have a Brandon 6 on turn 2. I'm just gonna go Scalding turn go. Cause if we go underground, yeah, I can't cast Brandon turn 2. Then I return a fetch land, and then I have a Wasteland plus Bren to just kinda go off with. Oh, Ancient Grudge. Is that a Chalice? It's a Ratchet Bomb. Do I mind? I don't think I mind. That would resolve. Dazing on the play is pretty bad. Alright. So let's get a Tropical Island. Then I think I can play a Badland for my Brandon 6 here. Which will plus and get me back that Scalding Tar. Next turn I can go Wasteland and then get back that Wasteland. Maybe you could cut the land with this deck. I think the day Brandon 6 does help you get there with your land drops. Maybe we should have fetched and get like a Volcanic Island just in case. Because I need to dates now, and then I want to Wasteland and play like a Ponder on top of the deck. This thing is unexpected in Legacy, but it's fine. Alright, so I'm gonna Wasteland. Okay, did not get punished since I don't want to cast Wasteland Brainstorm now. Gonna return to Wasteland, which is a very good card in a matchup. Riding 6 doing what it does best. Well, in order to play, I think this is a play that you can safely make, and it's gonna be very good. On the draw, maybe that won't be good enough. I think having 2 is the proper number in this configuration. Many other matchups you want 3. Alright, so Bren will die. Do they also have an Ancient Tomb? Now, hopefully not. You can deck and go Ancient Tomb like Green Monolith. Or Blast Zone. That'll be fine. I don't think I want the Blast Zone. I don't think I want to Wasteland that. I'll draw Tropical Island. Now I really wish I had a blue land in my hand instead of a bad land. Sorry, in play instead of a bad land. It's fine. I don't want to Wasteland the Blast Zone. I'm gonna wait for them to cast a better land. Also, I really want to just go, like, island, tropical island here. If they just have, like, you know, Dark Steel Citadel kind of land, I don't mind. Voltaiki. They should upgrade the Voltaiki to the new one, the one that untaps. Sorry, makes the creatures unblockable. Alright, let's go for a Brainstorm here. I have 2 lands to shuffle away. Okay, so that'll be this and this. And over. Yeah, that bad land there was definitely bad. It was a bad land. Lesson learned, you want to just... I mean, this is Delver deck with Daze. You definitely want to just have all the blue land first before playing any non-blue land. Yep. Deck was shuffled, so it's on top. Force of Will. Also known as the Good Force. Not that Force of Negation is bad, but you know. Alright, yeah, I mean, this game is over. I'm gonna Wasteland the Glimmer Post. Blast Zone is not threatening. Duplicate counter or the copy? Sure. Oh, with zero counters, that's sweet. Alright, it doesn't matter. It's basically the same thing as Marit Lage, right? Alright, that's a Claude Post, that's why we killed a Glimmer Post. I'm gonna date most likely anything. I mean, actually, Walking Ballista could just be the only one that I don't date here, because what's it gonna do? Honestly, nothing, right? This is a Mug Fanatic. I'm not afraid of a Mug Fanatic. This should be an Ancient Grudge also. So, yeah, I mean, I'm gonna slam that land. Yeah, whatever, our game is super much over. I mean, I could have Surgical to go Wasteland Surgical on the Cloud Pause, but I don't think that's a successful plan. I don't want to put out any blue card because of my forces. My many forces. I don't want to put out much here. Maybe Winter Orb is not as good as a picture. And I think in some games it will be good, like in the late game, maybe you can lose to Iavugan. Yeah, I think I'm gonna stick with this. Let's go. Alright, another wonderful hand. Replicate Lightning Bolt Delver. There's not a single colorless mana among them, and all of them cost differently. It's kind of weird, but this is Legacy indeed. I could even go like Trop Badland to... I think I'm gonna ignore... it's risky to ignore the Cloud Post, because if they go like another Cloud Post, and they just add extra mana, and they can go like Spyglass. So it's safer to just do this than just go Delver and then start disrupting them. Alright. Don't need to fetch Badland because I just drew it. So I'm gonna go Delver first, and then with Ponder I can look for something. I'm not afraid of Chalice of the Void because they have Abrupt Decay. Great Monolith. Play Thoughtseer. Thoughtseer is very annoying. Okay, well Taiki. So they have 5 mana now. What's for 5 mana that's very threatening? I mean, the Relentless Measure is very threatening. Congregate Creator is... it's a reasonably big deal. They can't go Walking Ballista, or they go plus. Okay. Alright. I'm definitely gonna go Brainstorming Upkeep. This time around, I won't misclick. So that I can bolt the card and kill it. Ooh, Force of Will, that's great. Do we even want to shuffle something away? I don't think so, right? I'm gonna just put a polluted Delta and a Bolt on top of my deck. I don't even want to shuffle the land here. I think I want to draw all of these 8 cards. So I'm gonna go yes. Draw. Then I'm gonna go Badland. We'll Taiki the Karn and attack the Karn. Now, next turn, I can even Abrupt Decay the Grim Monolith. They have right now 5 mana, but we have 4. Oh, they have 7 mana. Alright, they have a lot of mana, so I'm not gonna care about their lands anymore at this point. I'm just gonna... what is bigger, Tarmogoyf or True Name? I think I just wanna go... so if I go Ponder, I could draw 1 card, but what can it be? What is the one card that's great? I don't think Wasteland does too much now. I guess it still does. True Name Nemesis is a pitch for force, but it cannot be killed by my opponent. I think it's better if I keep True Name as a pitch for force and just looking for... yeah. This is not bad. Next turn I can go Tarmogoyf Delver. I mean, this time I'm gonna shuffle. I'm gonna just draw Tarmogoyf here to follow it up with more Tarmogoyf next turn. Shuffle the Robbery. No. So Polluted Delta is gonna get another Trop. That's the only green land that I have. And now Tarmogoyf is a 4/5. Was missing Sorcerer apparently, so Tarmogoyf confirmed better than True Nemesis. So now what we need to
avoid is our opponent just draw something uncounterable, like, I don't know, an Emrakul. I don't think they might even be very close to play it today. 4, 10, 12 mana. 14 mana right now, so they can still play Emrakul, but very close to lose. Okay, now they can, easily. Alright, so what we need to do is just clock them. I did shuffle the deck, but the Vortigern is still on top, that's funny. I don't want to Vortigern anything, I'm just going to play Tarmogoyf here, attack them for 7 now, and 11 that next turn. That is not going to be lethal, but still put my opponent in a very, very, very quick clock. Also, if I Vortigern an artifact, it is going to be lethal next turn. So as I put and draw something uncountable now, like as I said, an Emrakul, they die. Yep, and that's the recipe for the win in this matchup. Alright. So let's Abrupt Decay whatever, and that'll be 13 damage. And the Elver deck confirmed great. We did lose game one, but because he didn't find any wasteland. This game opponent just did nothing. I just played a Karn, which is not great against the Delver plus Lightning Bolt, which we were kind of lucky to have since I left only two, and maybe you should always supposed to keep four bolts against this deck because of Karn Great Creator that I honestly forgot about it. So yeah, pretty neat win. Round number one, let's be back for round number two. Alright. Tisn't solid. Doesn't do anything. Classic Legacy hand, but it could do much. Could have three cantrips and two counters. Let's have the bad land, just keep on being awful, but that is a life. Alright, Island go. Island go means usually miracles. Also, very Italian, and all the Italian players literally only play miracles. So that's what I'm gonna, that's where I'm gonna put my money on, and I don't want these cards. You'll wonder, then, what cards do you want? I don't know, but not two Tarmogoyf on the land. Maybe that was good enough, but I don't know. Alright, of course, as predicted. We're against Miracles. Wasteland. Sure, let's play this Tarmogoyf. I don't know what's up with Italians in Legacy. But whenever I go to literally any event, I don't go away from my house if I don't have a very, very good plan against Miracles, because I know that they are going to play against it for sure. Alright, that's a good play. Opponent did not play around these, which kind of showed by the fact that I have pet land, so it's totally fine for that to not play around these there. Could play the Dreadored Arcanist, but I think I kind of want to just... Yeah, I think I will actually. Yeah, I think I will actually play Dreadored Arcanist. This is very good. Maybe you should play more Dreadored Arcanist and less Tarmogoyf. I don't know. I could have Wastelanded, but then I would just have to waste a turn with that Badland up. That Badland keeps on being pretty awful, by the way. Alright. Scalding Tarn. Yeah, I'm gonna start off with a Ponder, and I'm probably just gonna go... Abrupt Decay is needed for, I think I'm gonna draw these. Abrupt Decay is needed for counterbalance, and I really like the Wastelander lands. If they play Tundra, it means they don't have any more lands in their hand. So I like to just attack them. That would mean I need to draw another land, because I'm gonna draw Abrupt Decay. Maybe I could just fetch. I don't know. Let's see if they've played Jace here. If they play Jace, I'm gonna date it. If they play Mentor number 2, okay, they don't. So we'll date it again. Alright, it worked. So here I'm drawing an Abrupt Decay. The question is, do I want to draw that fetch land? I think that's okay. I think it's more problematic the fact that they have a 4 mana. And it could play another chase next turn. Alright, I do steal the 4 mana. So I'm gonna drop a Looted Delta and I'll pass the turn. Next turn, I'll play Brainstorm with Scalding Tarn up. It's very important. The sequencing there is very important. Had we fetched to not draw the Polluted Delta, we couldn't have been able to do that. Alright, I think I'm gonna go for Brainstorm now. I could have a counterspell and etc. I could just upkeep something, but this way I can follow it up with some actual spell this turn, which will be a run on 6. That will give me back a wasteland. Even though maybe, yeah, I think a wasteland is better than a fetch land now. Let's see if they fight it. Alright, they daze me. Yeah, this might be Claudio Bonanni's deck list. He loves 4 mentor main and dazes. It's okay. I did not play around dazes, but I don't think it's that bad. Alright, play another land. Actually, I'm gonna top like this. Yes. What is a 5/6 currently? I could have Snapcaster Mage. This is why, you know, the Miracles always beats the Delver decks, because later in the game they just have Snapcaster Mage, and that's just huge. You know, there's a 2-1 body that will attack, that could do something, and meanwhile just flashbacking plows. Yeah, I don't want to probably kill Snapcaster Mage for sure. Just let him do that. If I draw another random 6, which play 3 of, I can pink the Snapcaster Mage, which is sweet. So I'll go to 24. I have plenty of life total to take from this Snapcaster Mage. I don't wanna use one of these counter. They are playing counterbalance and monster mentor, as you can see. So I'm gonna go end of turn, nothing, I just untap. And I'll play an abrupt decay on the mentor. And I will pass the turn with all kind of counter in hand, just in case I draw one brainstorm. It's pretty unfortunate that we did open our hand with 3 cantrip and never draw another cantrip. So that is definitely something bad. We did keep a pretty bad ponder with a wasteland and a ponder and a land. That was maybe should have shuffled. Who knows? Alright, that's a daze. Yeah, so we have plenty of cards to discard if we draw that brainstorm. The problem is drawing that brainstorm. And this is what makes Legacy great. You just can't play those like cheap cards like Daze and etc. and then in the late game just brainstorm them away like our opponent did just now with that fetch. Maybe they had like a Terminus on top. And if I did play like a Trunium Nemesis, they would have played a Terminus instead. I didn't do anything, so they just shuffled. Oh, 20 already. But I just saw my opponent play lots of cantrips. We do play only 8 cantrips, so it's obviously more likely for our opponent to draw them than for us. Augur of Pulse. Wow, that is unexpected, my friend. What is Augur of Pulse gonna do? It's gonna miss. It's gonna hit Brainstorm. Wow. That is sweet. Can I get a spell? No? Okay, I think I'm gonna line up this Snapcaster Mage. I'm gonna keep Abrupt Decay in hand because of Counterbalance and Mentor. Very jealous of my opponent drawing all those cantrips. Maybe, you know what, I'm just gonna take 3 more. I don't think it's gonna matter. 3 life. Augur of Bolas. Alrighty. Four cards in their hand. What is going to happen here? What is going to happen? Usually I board out Wasteland this matchup whenever I play Delver. I think I'll do it this time around too. Maybe you just keep 1 because you have Ren 6. But so I don't have a lot of things to board in here. I could go double the days, but I how am I winning this game? Whatever, let's go double days. I drew all days, it's pretty funny. I drew every copy of days, but yeah, if I draw Brian 6, maybe I can still be in the game. I ping the Snapcaster Mage. And then I alright, I go Force. Wow. Pitch what? Brainstorm. That's impressive. Yeah, they feel like they need to stick a Jace to just take over the game with like Jace Plus. They definitely need a plus though. If they go brainstorm, that's not very good. Yeah. They plus themselves because they have fetch land. Maybe they know the card, I don't know. Put to the bottom. I'm pretty sure there's no Assassin's Trophy on Abrupt Decay. There's a Tarmogoyf. I honestly don't know what to do here. I'll just click on my cards. And I'll pause the turn. This is really a throwback to the metagame. Back in the days of counterbalance top versus Deathrite Shaman. Those time, our opponent. Vamos. Okay. Alright, I could brainstorm wisely. Next turn, if really nothing happens, I could kill both of their creatures and kill Jace, but that is a very unlikely outcome. Yep. They did play three plows. I mean, four if you count that one of them was Snapcastered back. Alright. If I don't draw a good card, I'll concede. That is not a good card. Okay. Alright. Do have a lot of cyber for this matchup. So this 7. Sure about Force of Negation. I think it's better than many things here. Usually I hate Daze. I don't know if I wanna board out Daze though with Force of Will in my deck. I think so. Dodici. So I have 17 cards. It's a very small number. Very, very small number. But I think that's okay. I think you can set up a situation where you just don't play your Delver later in the game and just use your Force of Will. I think that's okay. I like keeping all the Lightning Bolts and Abrupt Decay against the deck with Dades because it means that they're on the version of 4 Mentor. So I want all the Lightning Bolts. And let's go with this. Alright, round 2. One to be a good game. It started with a Ponder and round 6 on a Daze, but in the end, with my opponent just being disconnected and dying of a very sad death, which is the death for disconnection. So we are 2-0, despite being actually down a game that game, though. This game looks pretty good if you think about it. Round 6 returning fetch, it's pretty powerhouse in this matchup. And yep, we are going to move to round number 3. Remember that this is ChannelFireball.com, so you can check ChannelFireball price cards on the website. And remember that they also buy your cards, not only sell them, by checking ChannelFireball.com/buy list. Round number 3, this is the point we already played at Dino Belcher Big Boys. They were playing some sort of, mirror match decks. Maybe without Delver. Alright, Underground Sea End. Underground Sea means no Brennan 6 though. So maybe they changed deck. Who knows? Alright, Underground Sea Ponder. I'm gonna go with, I don't know. Maybe if they shuffle, they can Wasteland. They did shuffle. Yeah, I'm gonna Wasteland them. Yeah, why not? Let's get in that Wasteland. And Bedlam now. And Invocation Thoughtseize. Which is gonna get rid of, I have two Ren 6. Man's kinda bad. Well, one of them, okay. With a Force for the other. And Force of Will. Okay, we need to get that land. Maybe we're supposed to not keep this opening. We're on the draw. I don't know. I don't think so. We play at the end of the day 16 colored sources on top of 8 cantrips. What is this? I could Force, but I'm trying to keep my Force for later. Sure, if I hit land trips now, it's upsetting. Already passed the turn. Wow, they don't have a land. If I draw one, it's upsetting because I, you know, could have had already Ren 6 in play. But if I don't, I just have a Force of Will more in my hand, which is obviously Very much welcome. Wow, they draw land. Okay, that's bad. Oh, that's bad. Now we really need to... At the bottom or to the top? Okay. Need to draw land now or we'll lose. Land. Alright, what do we want here? I think I'm going to draw the trop now. Maybe the underground sea now, let's think. If they have a wasteland. No, I didn't know they'll play control inversion, right? Yeah, so I'm gonna go with I'm gonna go like this. Because next turn I'm gonna play Vren, and I'm gonna hit land drop that way. So next turn I'm gonna draw Brainstorm, which is gonna be a pitch for my Force of Will. So that I can protect my Brandon 6 from a Force of Will of my opponent's side. So they're gonna play a land here because they scratch to the top with Preordain. Maybe it's kind of ponder to the top, but I don't know, whatever. They'll decide what they wanna do. Just hope no like Discord spell now. If they play Brandon 6, oh yeah, whatever. That'll resolve. Yeah, looks like it's a Brandon 6. So they get back a land, which we will also do. Oh no, they don't do that. What is this? That's strange. They're thinking a lot about it. I don't know what should they think about it. If they have Rand, they should definitely cast it. I mean, I have two unknown cards. But yeah. Yeah, even the blue card sucks here, but it is what it is. Mm-hmm. So there's Scallion turn back. Jealous. So I'm gonna go draw Brainstorm. I'm gonna cast my Vren. I could play Brainstorm and just abdicate as Vren. Thinking now, because if I go Vren Wasteland, the next turn I draw an Underground Sea, I'll play it. Yeah, I think that's actually better. I don't want to play this Brainstorm because it's a pitch for my Force. But the question is, do I want to Wasteland something? I think so, yes. Wasteland that volcanic island. Sure, they can get it back, obviously, but that would still reduce their use of mana. Next turn, I draw Underground Sea, so I can just play like Abrupt Decay and leave Lightning Bolt and Brainstorm up. I'll also return to Wasteland in the meanwhile. And Vren plus Wasteland, it's a beating. And, you know, Vren of opponent prevents you from doing the Vren plus Wasteland. Alright, so that's his trophy. I'm gonna force this. I have no basics to search. Yeah, I have no basics to search, and I have a very good card on top of my deck, so I'm definitely gonna go force here. Hopefully they don't have Spell Pierce. I don't know why they should play Assassin's Trophy over Abrupt Decay, though. Mm-hmm. You're looking for Force of Will. Force of Negation will not work. Remember, Force of Negation only works in your opponent turn. So, alright, they found the Force of Will. Alright, so my Ren 6 is gone. I'm not gonna shuffle, because there's a good card on top. So the Wasteland plan did not work. They have three cards. What did they pitch? Not a Brainstorm. Okay, so I'm gonna go Abrupt Decay immediately. Then I'll pass. Yeah, Vren 6 even plays around Bolt, which is a pretty big deal. Obviously, this deck cannot play Trophy because you don't want to give your opponent basics because you play Wasteland, you know? Whereas our opponent says, I don't care if you get land, I just want to be able to deal with, I don't know, Marit Lage, Jace, and so on and so forth. It can even be a sinkhole sometimes. That's a Jace. Definitely gonna go plus, but yeah, now I wish you Robert to get the Assassin's Trophy. It's actually the second time that it came around. Maybe we should play a split to the K1 Trophy. Alright, top of deck, I don't know anything about it. But losing this game is kind of rough. If we hit a land drop earlier, it would have been in great shape, but it is what it is. I could bolt this in case I draw red swords, but I don't think so. And Tarmogoyf, it's the battlefield. They left my dates on top of the deck, so they know about my dates. They know also about my bolt, and I'm not sure about those of Rub Decay. Probably they don't know about it. Uh-huh. Once again, I think this game one against control decks is obviously going to be bad. I mean, Delver has always been bad against game ones, against control deck game ones. And now with this Rancy, it's been harder to mana screw them, which is usually the way you used to win. I guess Trim Nemesis is the only way you can actually win. Yeah, I'm going to concede this game. Dino Belcher Big Boys gets the first. I think I want to have Winter Orb. They definitely have Coil Against Command in their deck. Blood Plus is going to go in for sure. Five cards. What do you want to cut? I like everything here. Maybe just Thoughtseize is bad. What about Bolt? Wait. Bolt must be bad. And Bolt doesn't really kill anything. Doesn't kill Jace, doesn't kill Brandon 6. Maybe on the play I should just I should just do this. Yeah, I think Force of Will, I don't want Force of Will against the deck with a control deck we run on the blast. So this is gonna be my plan here. I don't think I want anything else. Let's go with this. Okay. Alright, I hate this hand. There's so much that I hate about this hand. I'll bottom a bolt, I think. Bottom a bolt, because the days on the play could be irrelevant. Blue Metal Blast can't kill Brandon 6. And the bolt is not particularly good. Yeah, not having a Delver or Tarmogoyf to start your tournament. To start your turn, it's pretty bad, but it is what it is. Alright, let's get our. What is the best configuration to start? Definitely a tropical island. I think just a volcanic island. I don't want to get a badland out. They have a daze if they have like blow mental blast here. And I hope they boarded a force of will. I mean, force of will is pretty bad against the deck with a mirror match with daze, and especially on the draw. So I'm not playing around force of will ever in this game. And Mulligan has been restored with this plus one. And if you plus one again, then it's gonna be great. We even have Brainstorm. Oh, now I'm gonna just. Now I'm just gonna get. Oh, Hydro Blast. Yeah. That is. That works. That's why people play Hydro Blast these days. Elemental Blast is the same. It's just cheaper. Alright, I'm gonna go Brainstorm with this Volk. Or maybe I just go Wasteland. Who knows? Nah, I'm not going to go for Wasteland. I'm gonna go Brainstorm. Protect myself from Spell Pierce. Shuffle two lands away. Shuffle Getty, Underground Sea, I think. Play a Ponder. Alright. Now let's play a Delver. The Power Blast and Tom to flip. I could have just drawn another Delver and then flip both of them with the Pyro Blast, but I think that's the sequence is actually better. I could also just, you know, just Wasteland it, but then I wouldn't play it around Spell Pierce or Flask of Storm, which your opponent could play. Yep. So we go Brainstorm, which is usually a sign of weakness, a sign of like being mana screwed, but obviously it could also mean anything. Literally mean anything. Alright, I play Ponder. I'm gonna just daze this. I don't have much to do with this daze regardless. And if our opponent is actually mana screwed, like I think it is, then it's a good play. Yeah, I guess now I regret having not wastelanded in Underground Sea, but it's okay. They're still locked up. So I'm gonna go yes. I'm gonna play Wasteland, kill the Underground Sea. Remember, they play a deck with Random 6, so you definitely wanna leave them with Underground Sea around. Sure, there were a bunch of black cards the deck could play, but alright, this is where Daze shines after Wasteland and opponent be mana screwed. Which is obviously not a common scenario, but on the draw I think I'm gonna cut the Dazes too. I'm just gonna cast this. Not playing around Force of Will. I just don't wanna bounce another land, because if I draw a Trunum Nemesis that I can cast. Oh, actually, I knew what I was drawing, so yeah, whatever, it doesn't really matter. They go to 13, and I have a Red Elemental Blast in hand, and the Blue Elemental Blast in hand, so Maybe the Hydro Blast will not do much. The Blue Metal Blast will not do much. Alright, they drew a land. They'll put them down to 12. If it is a Pillow Push, there's nothing they can do about it. Oh, a Taiga, wow. Just all the domain. Just all the dual lands for them. Alright. Looking for a Lightning Bolt, I think, so I'm gonna Blue Elemental Blast that. Immediately. Okay. Despite they have Tigers, they can't play Brennan 6, remember, because then they're gonna see it as not either red or green. So let's see a good old. Can I trip on top? Yes. Nice. I'm gonna tap the Underground Sea here. There's plenty of green cards I don't want to cast, like Tarmogoyf above all. It's just a bunch. Okay. I'm gonna kill the Taiga, because they could have more Bolt in their hand. They definitely don't have more cantrips. I already do, I guess. Well, I should have Pyroblast the Brainstorm. That was a mistake.
Sorry.
I had an overview here. They don't concede, which means that they still can't get out of this. They go down to 6. And we do have a Delver and a Daze on top of our deck. Alright, going to 5. Maybe they bolt one of these Delver. Yeah, should have definitely countered that Brainstorm. I just had the thumb on the number 1, which passes priority, and whenever I put on play Brainstorm, I just clicked it for some reason. Alright, so they're looking for red, and they play what? Punishing Fire. Fair enough. I can't counter that. So I'll play another 1 mana 3-2 flyer, because there's a Daze on top of the deck, so opponent now needs to kill both of them. Which that could do, honestly, if it's just a land double burn spell, land bolt punishing, and then just die after not countering that Brainstorm. Alright, I go to 1 though. Maybe, you know, I just have 3 bolts in my deck. Oh my god. That's amazing. Alright, opponent's still alive. 2 cards in hand, 1 life. We also have 2 cards in there, so we're basically equal, but we used to, you know, be in a losable position. That Pyroblast. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna counter this time, but even if Brennan 6 kills them. Do they have a Snapcaster Hydro Blast? No, they die. Alright. Our Grandet wins. So if I get rid of Dazes, even on the draw, what am I going to replace it with? There's not much. I mean, it could be a Bolt. I definitely don't want Winter Orb. I don't think this card is good. Maybe I should just keep the Dazes even on the draw. Yeah, maybe. At the end of the day, we have a. I don't know, actually, maybe I shouldn't. Choice. I'm gonna go with Dates. Yes, let's go with this. We have a land and a ponder, and that's usually what it takes to keep hands in Legacy. Whereas our opponents looking like they're decided to go to 6. Maybe even further. Alright. Scry to the bottom. I mean, oh, sorry. They put a card to the bottom. Yeah, I'm so used to just see the scry thing. All right. Let's get this thing going. We have a Daze, which when it starts with Underground Sea again, and they shuffle again. So, I mean, you don't start with Underground Sea in this deck. You definitely don't want to, because Brand 6 costs not Underground Sea mana. All right. This is all good cards. This is all very good cards. Let's see if they find a land. If they play cantrip here, I'll laze it. Alright, they don't. No, obviously I'm not gonna do the brainstorm
right now. Yeah, all they're doing is just looking for lands,
looks like. And they fetch. I'm not never gonna date a ponder, so that's the only thing that I can cast here. So I'm just going to play a wasteland on the volcanic island and pass the turn. Maybe I could also just play a land and play maybe a library to just play a Trunum Nemesis next turn. How do you describe top bottom? It's a Tarmogoyf on top, which I think I like in this matchup a lot. So I don't want to fetch. Maybe I just... Yeah, what if I just do this? What if I just do this? This way I still apply my Tarmogoyf next turn, because it's very good in this matchup. I could even go like Tarmogoyf Totsies. And I could also just draw extra cards, because this opponent is not going to threaten my life total. Okay, Tarmogoyf's less good against that. Alright, let's see. I don't think I want to take 8. But maybe I'm even not drawing Tarmogoyf now. Huh. These two cards are not very good. What if I just bottom? I mean, now maybe I should draw Tarmogoyf. Maybe I should just play Trinum Nemesis this turn.
It's very bad if they have a Diabolic Edict of some sort,
which they could have in their deck. What if I draw the Lightning Bolt only? And I go under a Polluted Delta 4, a Underground Sea. That will not make me cast Lightning Bolt, but I don't think that's a problem. I'm gonna go like that. So I'm gonna go this, pay 4. So I'm gonna go with Underground Sea, Thought Seas. I don't wanna take Badland. I mean, it's just too blue to take Badland here. And I think Lightning Bolt is the superior to a Private Decay if I wanna kill the Baleful Strix with it. Was the major punishing fire? Alright. Snapcaster Mage is definitely gonna take the hit. So they kept in Force of Will against me. Strange. Alright. So their hand sucks, which I'm very happy about. They even fetch an upkeep to not draw, I guess, the top card. Which I don't know what it was, obviously, but they scryed it there with the preordain. Oh, actually they didn't. No, just fetch for value there. I don't know which value could there be with a fetch land there, but that is what happened. So I need all land to cast my bolt. There I find it. Let's see if what else do we have. I don't think I want to draw 4 more lives. I'm gonna just go top. I'll go mountain, lightning bolt. There's an artifact now in the graveyard. So attack for 5, usually Tarmogoyf is very good in this matchup. Then I'll play Trunum Nemesis, and then hopefully this will be enough to kill my opponent next turn. Next turn I could even double Wasteland if I feel like it. As you can see, like this game, Wastelanding was wrong. Sure, opponent gave us the idea that they were mana screwed, but they weren't. Luckily, we did not bait this time. I mean, earlier they just missed a land drop, so it wasn't baiting, it was just actually be mana screwed. This time they could have made us think that they were mana screwed. Alright, what's this? Leovold? Pernicious Deed. That is annoying. So I could go Daze. Just to make so that I can't kill both of my things. I think I'm gonna actually go for Daze here. So this Daze won't be, you know, particularly good. Maybe they wouldn't have cracked the Pernicious Deed. Who knows? Alright, I'm gonna kind of want to just lose 8 this time around. Because I know the Sealed Ivory is gonna die. I guess I could find an Abrupt Decay. Compound Abrupt Decay. Lightning Bolt. So this turn I attack for 8, they go down to 5. Alright, what if I just lose 8? I think at 5 life, I think I'm safe. I think I'm safe at 5 life. Alright, so what do we want to do here? I'll definitely attack. Do I want to just play a Brainstorm first? Oh, actually, I can't find Abrupt Decay now. Alright, did not get punished, luckily. What do I want to do here? Double Wasteland or something else? I think Double Wasteland is okay. So I'm going to just put on top of my deck these two cards. Then I'm going to Wasteland... list of the green sources. Or maybe the red sources, because they have Punishing Fire in their hand. And then I'll attack them down to 5. And then hopefully the Tarmogoyf will finish them off. If I did not play Daze, maybe the Pernicious Deed would have killed the Tarmogoyf single library. I wouldn't have drawn 2 extra cards, and it would have been a 10 life. So I think I'm happy with this. I mean, I could die to a... Alright, what's this? 3? Is this a Plague Engineer? Or did I just crack the deed? Yeah. Alright, good enough. I don't think I want to bowl them. I'll just untap. Play my Tarmogoyf for sure. I think that's it. I need to protect myself from a Jace. I don't think it makes any sense to play Delver. Even though Delver does. Let's see what they do here. Okay, this is resolved. Actually, no, if I play Delver, they can't Jace bounce. They just die, because on top of the deck, there's a Brainstorm. Playing Delver is bad against what? Not much, honestly. Let's just play Delver. I could die to double, like, Lightning Bolt plus Punishing Fire, if they have it, because I'm on 5 life, remember? But, I mean, I guess they need double red to do that, so they have, like, the 2 burn spell already, and they draw the red source, so that's pretty unlikely. They fetch down to 4. Remember, I have a Bolt in my hand. We know about Force of Will and Punishing Fire, but... Alright, so it's all about Tarmogoyf. If they find another Tarmogoyf, it's gonna be hard. They say GG. Alright, so it looks like we won. Good thing. Show me the hand. Wow, it was exactly that. It was just burn spells. They needed a land to draw, to play burn. Maybe I should just play this untapped. What if they go, like, Abrupt Decay on this, pass the turn, and then I just... I don't know. Maybe I should not play Delver. Alright, we are 3-0. Even though this match was sketchy. Let's be back for round number 4. Round number 4 on the play with my trusty Land Ponder. Actually, I don't even have Ponder, I just have Land Delver, but that's good enough. So on turn 2, I can run the Brainstorm, so I'll see the top 5 cards before missing a land drop. Which, I mean, could happen, but hopefully it won't. Let me know our opponent mulligan to 6, and yep, we have a game. Pull the Delta, so it's going to be another blue deck. Ooh, Lotus Petal, okay. It is a combo deck. Usually this deck is very good against combo, especially for sideboard. Right, definitely not a blue deck then. Like a Reanimator, it's been a while. I kind of love to play against this combo deck because it's fast games. It's nice magic. Mm-hmm. Are you going to reanimate the Chancellor? Alright, then I can see the game. And that's it. Wrestling, 3 wins. So I want Surgical, I want Edicts, I want Force, and that could be it. I dislike probably just random bolts. Abrupt Decay, actually. It's awful. Abrupt Decay does kill... Animate Dead, maybe. You can keep one. But Vryn is actually definitely bad in this matchup. Lightning Bolt could finish them off, and that's pretty relevant sometimes. Yeah, I think I'm happy with this configuration. Let's go with this. On the play, after losing game 1 very swiftly, with a reasonable hand, I'm gonna go turn 1 Delver. Always the best card against any combo deck. Because, sure, I mean, if they have the perfect hand, you die. There's nothing to do about it. But if they instead slow down, Delver does not give them much time. And this is definitely the reason why any Delver deck is good against combo. Alright, they have Chancellor. So, never mind, just play Land and Pass. Change of plan, Chancellor revealed. I can still Daze. Daze plays pretty well around Chancellor. Just don't want to do anything unfair. A Petal to kick things off. I have those Petals in real life, those are nice. Unmask, pitching Cabal Therapy. I'm thinking I'm going Daze here. Because If they pay for the days, it's good, right? If they don't, then I think it's good on them. We still counter the Chancellor play. Like now, we could play a one drop if we want. We still have to make a land drop. Alright, I passed the turn, that's nice. I think I'm gonna go ponder here. I said out Delver is the best start, but because it dates, now that I don't, I need to find a Force of Will ASAP. I found it. I also found a Abrupt Decay, which is very bad, especially because I have a Volcanic Island in play. Oh, they concede. It's a very premature concession, but I guess they can do whatever they want. And I like the sounds of this. Let's go. Maybe I should have like a Blue Elemental Blast. I don't know why I didn't board it in. Sorry, guys. It's both below for my Force and it counters some things, so I should definitely board it in. Let's go for round number three. Game number three. Alright, we have plenty of Forces. Cannot mulligan this hand. Let's see if they have a Chancellor. Hopefully not. Alright, nice. Nice, nice, nice. And Faithless Looting. Okay. Not having a turn one play, it's rough, but I have three Forces. I can't mulligan this hand. Alright. Still haven't seen a single Grizzle Brand on my opponent's side, but. Ooh, Wasteland. Hello. Hello, Wasteland. I kept both all four Wastelands just because they do have Faithless Looting and they. Wow. We want to go Force Pitch Force. Maybe the name's Surgical. Let's try to resolve. Even if this is got Force of Will, I mean, I do have another Force of Negation, luckily. If I had three Force of Will, maybe I could have done it. Alright, yep. That's a good 2-for-1, but there's no way for me to avoid that 2-for-1 there. Maybe I should have Force of Negation, the Faithless Looting. I didn't consider that play, but maybe that was actually a right play to make. Who knows? It wasn't. Because they still have Entomb as a way to put cards in the graveyard, so I'm only gonna go for countering the reanimate or whatever they have. Grizzle Brand. I think I'm gonna fetch end of turn here for a Tropical Island. They tried if I have 6. Nice try. Or I still in 3, but I did not have 6. With a Force of Negation in my hand. Alright, they have one card in hand. Best draw would obviously be Surgical Extraction. Or just them not to draw a reanimation card. Wasteland, I don't think it. I mean, I could play it. Just in case I draw a Brainstorm, it's better to keep the Wasteland around, but. They can finish with Faithless Looting, I guess, this way. Yeah, that was wrong. You know what? It's not that bad, because if I finish with Faithless Looting, then they have to sacrifice the petal, at which point my Wasteland on the Badland will mean that they can't cast 2 drops. So maybe it's not that bad. I mean, they did discard 2 unplayable cards, so. I don't know. It goes both ways. Alright, dates. I don't know. Actually, I don't mind. Maybe. This actually played around better. Okay, the Tarmogoyf is not messing around, and you see why the Dreadnought Arcanist, Tarmogoyf is better than Dreadnought Arcanist sometimes. Because this time around there's nothing to flashback. Imagine having a 5-6 against a 1-3. Let's hope they don't have a reanimate. Alright. I think I'm gonna pay 2 mana. I'll get Mountain. Maybe get Badland here, actually. If I draw Wasteland, I can't cast my true name. But if I draw a Diabolic Edict, yeah, I'm definitely gonna get take Badland. I should have. Yeah, no, this is fine. It's only Wasteland that doesn't make me play true name, but if I draw one of the many black cards that I have, it's pretty bad. Alright, they say Brutal, but they're still not dead, so they should definitely continue playing here. That was really lucky, they say. Yes, Mr. Reanimator deck, that was very lucky. Your deck instead is pure skill. Alright, that's a land. And I'll get a whatever land, play my Trunam Nemesis, which now is gonna make me play around maybe even Grizzlebrand? No, not really. I mean, I'm gonna play me around Reanimate for Grizzlebrand, but if they exhume or animate that Grizzlebrand, there's nothing. The Trunam would not help me winning the race. Alright, so we need to dodge something. So I just have to hope they don't draw a reanimation card now. So we silently wait. They say something. They say top decked, reanimate, GG. GG, Mr. Wrestling number 3. Sorry. Crazy. Anyway, yes, opponent might have been new to the game of Magic the Gathering, where drawing from top of the deck is one of the most important skills. Alright, 4-0. Let's see if we can get that trophy. Alright, final round for the trophy. We got a fine hand on the draw with a Delver of Secrets and a couple of forces. And of course, Brainstorm. And of course, Brainstorm. Ooh, Ancient Tomb. Alright, I'm gonna go Force. Yeah, I mean, any deck that starts with Ancient Tomb, they must play a Chalice afterwards. What if I just pitch a Force? I think I will. It's bad if they have another Chalice, because I'm gonna go Delver on turn 1. But if instead... maybe I should have gone Wasteland. I don't know why, but I had my mouse over the Volcanic regardless of what I draw. Maybe I should have Wastelanded. Ooh, Mountain. Yeah, I should have definitely Wastelanded. Oh, I'm so stupid. Why didn't I Wasteland it? Ooh, a Braid. Oof. Oof, so much better. I was so scared. Classic Volcanic Island Abrupt Decay interaction in the meanwhile for us. Two Volcanic Island. Yeah. Alright, let's go for Brainstorm. What do you want to shuffle away? I think 1 Decay, 1 Brainstorm, I think it's fair to shuffle away. Then next turn I'll play True Name. Yeah. So let's get a Underground Sea. This card in. Kind of Flame Caller. That's pretty expensive. Discard and probably just Seeding Song, or maybe. So what's my point of playing? I have no clue, honestly. Discard. And actually, I don't mind about these. I'm just gonna discard Seeding Song. I don't know. Maybe I should have discarded the other ones. This one just doesn't do much. All right, so big red for the final, for the trophy. I should have taken Blood Boon, because if they draw double land, I lose. Yeah, I was so stupid. Why did I do that? Oh my god. Yeah, I just deserve a loss. Ooh, is there a Bridge deck play? Okay. It's still very bad. Still very bad. If I just take the Blood Moon there, for some reason, it's just... I don't know how to explain my plays. Alright. Now, all I hope is that they... I don't know, just don't play much. What I was thinking is that I have Abrupt Decay, I'm not afraid of Blood Moon or Bridge because it just can float mana or kill the Bridge, but obviously what happens is that opponent draws a double land and they play their things, so I should have discarded them. And so I discarded Seeding Song because I was afraid of things like Sneak Attack and then dying to anything. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I lose the game here. Alright. Alright, it's okay. We can just give up a game. It doesn't matter. Deck is very good. We'll be winning game 2 and 3, don't worry. Don't worry, guys. Do we like rank 6 in this matchup? Maybe not much. Yeah, I think this is gonna be a fine sideboarding. Let's go with this. Pretty upset of having thrown out a game that way, but that's okay. We'll be winning the next two. This kind of shows the power of this deck, though, if you think about it. We just give up a game here and there, and we're still 4-0. If we just discard Bloodborne there, there's no way we lose that game, because we have a part of the game for the bridge, and then we have Days for the Child, right? Just very, very easy. Alright, Chalice. Okay, that's fine. I can't cast anything from my hand. Snow covered. Snow covered mountain. Mm-hmm. We're patiently waiting to draw a Abrupt Decay here. That's a Chrome Mox. Mm-hmm. Pitching a. What's this? Chandra Awakened Inferno. Yeah, I'm gonna Force of Negation a Blood Moon. I don't have any basics in my deck. This is not a control deck. This is a Delver deck, so no basics for us. Still waiting on that Abrupt Decay. If that happens, maybe there's a shot. Or a Ratchet Bomb, I don't care. Abrupt Decay. Tarmogoyf, that's large. And I'm not gonna play Wasteland. I'm not gonna play the Island. I'm just gonna pass the turn here. Ratchet Bomb can kill a Tarmogoyf. That's gonna be fine. Alright, it's another bomb into Fury Confluence, and is there a Blood Moon? That is. And I'm gonna Reckless Concede. Alright, the league has ended. Finally. Okay, could have gone better. Maybe it could have been the fifth of the game 3 there, and maybe the trophy. I hope you still got to add a good time to show this Brand 6 paired with Delver. Pretty cool card. We'll see more with the other deck that I'm gonna play next. It's gonna be the control deck. I don't know if ChannelFireball will publish them in their other order. In any case, this is the played first. And now, next up is the control version. Thanks for watching. We'll be back for more Legacy videos. Remember to subscribe to the channel to see more of these. Goodbye.